Hello, it's Tina with TSR Creations, back again with another video, and I am going to do a beach scene in resin. So I'm going to go step by step. It's really not that difficult. Today I'm using a 12 by 24 cradle wood board. It's pre-gessoed. It's by Da Vinci. It's called Pro Panels. These are great. Pre-gessoed, smooth, it's thick, and I tape the sides because the sides are natural, so they are going to stay that way. So I don't want it to go, you know, over the sides, and if the resin does go over the sides, I'll be able to peel it up. Okay, so just make sure that the tape is nice and secure. And then I'm going to get all my pigments together. I'm going to use mica powders. I'm going to be using sand. First step is I paint my board with to look like an ocean. I did another video where I have a clock. So basically the same thing, but this time I'm going to be adding a beach. And I'll show you how I do that. All right, so I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So I have, I just use an egg carton for my palette. And these are some of these colors I've used before. So we're going to be using Prussian blue, turquoise, probably a lighter turquoise, and the ultramarine blue. I have my white. I'm going to mix these as I'll show you how to shade it or to fade it. And then for the sand, I use a mixture. This is my sand. So this is parchment. It's called the color. It's just a tan paint, glue all, and sand. And it makes a sticky, clumpy mess. But this is going to hold my shells and all my goodies that I place in the sand. Okay, so this is my sand mixture. Again, glue all to a thick mixture. Okay. All right, so you have to need to get a brush, decent sized brush, wet it a little bit. And I'm going to start, I think I'm going to do, I usually do the beach scenes this way. I think I'm going to do this one going this way. So my beach is going to be down here. And then my waves are going to, my water's going to come in this way. So I'm going to kind of do a, you'll see. All right, so the blue is going to go up here. This is the darker of the blues. This is Prussian blue. And just so you see, we're going to go, and I'll speed this up in a minute. All right, so wipe your brush off a little bit, and we're going to go in with a little bit of the, we're going to go in with the ultramarine, and you're going to blend them in. And being this is a wood panel, it may take another coat. Because a canvas will like absorb it. This does not. Okay, and then you're gonna go in with another lighter color. And this one I'm just gonna actually add a little white to my ultramarine. And just mix it up a little bit before I do the turquoise. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect because you're going to be going over it with pigments. Possibly, if you want to, you don't have to. You can just go in with clear at this if you're going to be painting the background. But I always put in a little micas to my paints. All right, so basically, I'm going to fade this down. I'm going to do a little bit of the turquoise blue. right in. Now just kind of do it how you think you want it to look. I'm gonna go in with a little bit of the lighter turquoise with the white. Blend that in. Okay. And then a little bit more white. Okay. Okay, so now I'm gonna wash my brush off. I have a little bit of that parchment, the tan color, and I'm going to just push this down here before I put the sand on. And I'm gonna blend it kind of into the other turquoise. So it looks like it's underneath the water. You can change brushes. I just was lazy and I didn't want to. Okay. Okay. That's good. All right. So real quick, I'm going to do this part. So this is the sand, and I'm going to put my sand in right in here. And I'm just going to spread it on. Because it's thick, and I want it to be thick. So I want it to, it's going to be three-dimensional. And it can be uneven because, you know, the shoreline is not even. And you don't have to worry about the edge or the side. And just kind of like pat it down to make it, give it that rough texture. Make it thick. Drip like I just did. Okay, and this is going to be a foundation for any shells or any embellishments that you want to add to your beach. Okay. Blend in a little bit. So I'm just gonna speed this up, okay? I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So you saw me, I put down my shells and my glass. So I just wanted to show you really quick because I didn't mean to have it on fast. I put in these little shells, and these are from, I got these on Amazon, I believe. And then I put in glass shavings. Turquoise glass shavings. I just have them in a cup here, but these come in a bag and you can get them at Michael's. And then I put in some real shells that I found on my beach, because I live near the beach. and a rock, little rock, and some glass beads. And you put those right into your sand. The glue is going to hold them on there. Also, we're going to have a little resin kind of going over that too. So I mixed up all my resin. I'm using about 4 ounces for this. It's probably not going to use it all. Maybe. Probably not. I decided, because I like the way my paint came out, the colors, I'm just going to use clear and white for my beach waves. So I will show you how we do that. So in a little cup, I'm just going to take some resin. It's probably way more than I need. And I'm going to add white tint. Now this is, the resin I use is K resin. I like this for art projects. I use all different kinds of resin, but this is a white base tint, and this is by Stone Coat Countertop Resin. Really like their resin. They're just, it's expensive. And I'll use that if I'm doing anything that needs, you know, like heat resistance, or anything like that. But anyway, so this is a white base tint, okay? And you're gonna add some of this, not a lot, to the resin. I don't wanna, I'll show you, okay. I'll probably just do another little scoop, okay? And let's mix it up. Okay. So these are going to be for the waves. And I just, when I put the cup down, I messed that up. That's right. We'll have waves over there. Okay. And also into this, I'm going to put a couple drops of white alcohol ink. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Mix it up good. Okay, put that aside. I'm going to lay down the clear. Gonna heat it up a little because there's a ton of bubbles. And I'm just gonna spread this out. Don't have to worry about the sides because we're going to be keeping those natural looking. It's a wood side. And I have my tape on. I'm just spreading it out. And I'll speed this part up. Okay. Alright. I'm just going to put another glove on. You can see that I smudged it. I should probably let it dry quite long enough because I wanted to show you the video. But that's okay. I'm going to cover that up with my beach waves. Alright, so now I'm going to take the white that I mixed and I'm going to put in a wave here. Put in a wave here. Start with that. All right. So now you're gonna gonna take your heat gun. I'm gonna heat this up. And push. Push. Push a little on to the beach. Just real quick, I want to break these up a little bit. The edge there. All right. So far, so good. All right. I see a piece of sand in there. I mean, it's probably best when I wanted to, for video purposes, I should have let everything dry before I did the resin, but that's all right. For video purposes, I wanted to just get it done. So I have a little bit more clear here. I'm just gonna put this here. Go in with a little bit more white. And I'm just taking a little bit of the resin and going over the shells. I might blow up some of the white here. Okay. Speed this up for you. Okay, so you saw that I blew a little of the white into the stones and the shells because I want it to look like the water's coming up on those on the shore. And then I'm just kind of drizzling little lines of the white through my stones. And this is the white resin. Just kind of kind of. And then just heat it up a little bit, not much. It look like it's over the sand. It's coming up over the sand. All right. All right. Okay, and just make sure you don't have any, I want to torch it a little bit just to make sure I don't have any bubbles. Your sands all the way to the edge. If you need to, you can, this is when you can go in and just rough it up a little bit. Before it's set. Because it's, you know, sand. It's not perfect. All right. I see something in my resin. Let me get that out. Right here. This piece is pretty much done. I will keep checking on it because I feel like there's little somethings in there. Okay, what is that? Anyway, I will keep checking on this to make sure nothing gets into it. If you have a dust-free zone in your studio or in your house, which I don't know who does, you can put it there. I generally, sometimes I'll put it in like a big Tupperware, but today I'm just gonna be leaving this right here to stay. It should be fine. Pretty happy with this. It looks good. Very pretty, the colors, and I like the orientation. All right, if you have any questions, comment below. Please like and subscribe and all that stuff. You can always move your waves around too if you don't like the way they look. But I think this looks pretty. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.